I'd like to show you how to use our LabQuest Stream sensor interface to collect and analyze data from an iPad. LabQuest Stream is a special hardware device that allows Vernier sensors to interact with your iPad using Bluetooth wireless technology. Now with Stream, you can collect data from three analog sensors and two digital sensors simultaneously, and you can analyze this data on your iPad using our free graphical analysis app. Well, LabQuest Stream is battery powered, so let's get started by turning it on. Now, after I press the power button, the power LED will turn green and the Bluetooth LED will start flashing. This lets you know that it's ready for a connection. Now, if I don't connect to my Stream within 10 minutes, it'll automatically turn itself off in order to save battery power. But before I go any further, I'm going to flip my LabQuest Stream over and make note of the serial number that's on the back. This number is part of a unique name that helps you identify your Stream when you're trying to connect to it from our software. Now for my first example, I'm going to show you how to graph position versus time using our motion detector. Now our motion detector is a digital sensor, so I'm going to plug it into digital port 1 on my LabQuest Stream. Next, I'm going to go to my iPad and start up Vernier's graphical analysis app. Inside graphical analysis, I'm going to create an experiment and select LabQuest Stream as my data source. Now the iPad's going to go out and query all of the available LabQuest Streams in your classroom. But we already know that ours is numbered 1629, so we can go ahead and connect to it right away. Well, graphical analysis automatically figured out that I have a motion detector connected, so it set me up with a default graph. All I need to do now is move my hand up and down over the sensor and collect some data. And there I have a nice position versus time plot of my hand motion. Well, LabQuest Stream can also collect data from multiple sensors at the same time. This is critical when you need to time correlate events, such as force and position, in a collision experiment. But it can also help eliminate sources of error by acquiring data under identical operating conditions. Well, to demonstrate this capability, I'm going to do a simple experiment with a couple of hand dynamometers. I'm going to pit my right hand against my left hand to see which hand is stronger. Now before I do that, I'm going to disconnect my previous experiment and connect the dynamometers to analog channel 1 and analog channel 2. Now over on my iPad in graphical analysis, I'm going to start collecting data. And it looks like my right hand is connected to the red trace and my left hand is connected to the blue trace. Now I'm going to grip them both at the same time as hard as I can to see which hand is stronger. That should be enough. Well, it looked like my right hand won this time. If I select the data in this region, I can show some statistics if I want to look at it in a little bit more detail. And it also shows that I was losing my grip strength the longer I held onto the sensors. So I might want to turn on a linear curve fit and look at that slope in a little bit more detail. Now another great feature of LabQuest Stream is its ability to collect data using fast sample rates. Investigating sound waves is an easy way to demonstrate this. So I'll use a microphone to take a look at the tone generated by this tuning fork. Now to get started, I'm going to disconnect my dynamometers. And plug in my microphone to analog channel 1. Well, back on my iPad, graphical analysis is all ready to go. All I have to do now is get my tuning fork going. Well, here's how it sounds. Now let's collect some data to see how it looks. Well, you can see that we got a really nice sine wave from that tone. And if I go and look at the attributes of that plot, I can change the appearance to show both points and lines. And now you can see all of the underlying data samples that went into making that curve look so smooth. Well, the examples that I showed highlighted LabQuest Stream's compatibility with iPads, but Stream can also be used with Android devices, Chromebooks, and computers. And it supports both Bluetooth and USB connectivity. For more information about LabQuest Stream and our analysis software, please visit our website.